Let's introduce some terminology. The capacity is the size of array B, in this case, 9. The load factor is the size of the set divided by the capacity, in this case, 6 over 9, or 2/3. A probe is either a test of some BI to see whether it is null, or a comparison of a linked list element with some value. We investigate the number of probes to determine whether an element is in the set. An important point about the hash function is that it randomly directs elements to buckets. The diagram on the monitor shows one way in which the 6 elements could have been placed in the set, but just as likely, each of the 6 elements could have been placed in a single bucket, or all of them in one bucket. Consider searching for an element E that is not in the set, when all elements are in one bucket. In one possible case, 7 probes are made. The first probe finds that bucket B2 is a linked list, and then 6 probes determine that E is not in the list. In the other 8 cases, 1 probe is needed. Thus, on the average, 7 plus 8 divided by 9, or 15 divided by 9 probes, are needed. That's less than 2 probes. This kind of analysis can be made with all other configurations. In fact, someone has proved that if the load factor is 1/2, the expected or average number of probes is at most 2. Even if the set contains 1,000 elements, this is astonishing. This is why hashing is so effective and is used so often. But as the load factor increases past 1/2, the average number of probes needed to determine if an element is in the set increases. At some point, it is best to create a new array, hash all the elements into the new array, and use the new array. The default for the number of probes for Java's class hashSet is when the load factor reaches 3/4, 0.75. Here's a rehashing method. First, save a pointer to array B. Next, create a new array B and set the size to 0. The length of the new array is 3 times the size of the set. This method is also used to decrease the array size when the load factor gets too small. That's the reason for testing to make sure it doesn't get smaller than its initial capacity. Now, process each bucket in the original array. If it is a linked list, that is, it's not null, add each element of the linked list to the new array B. Note that the original method add is used. The last line of method add has to be changed. First, attempt to add the element to the linked list and store the result in a variable. Next, if the load factor is greater than 0.75, rehash. Note that the test is not made using an integer division because that would not work. The result of the division would typically be 0. Finally, the result of calling method add is returned. We do have to take into account the cost of the time of creating the new array and rehashing all the set elements into it. To do this, we introduce the notion of amortization in the following way. A year ago, we bought a SodaStream fizz maker, let's say for $100. We bought it to save money. We don't have to buy plastic bottles of fizzy water anymore because this machine adds fizz to a glass of water. Think about it this way. After making one glass of fizzy water with the machine, we said that the glass cost us $100. After making 2 glasses, we said that each glass cost us $50. After 100 glasses, each glass cost $1. After 1,000 glasses, each glass cost us 10 cents. We amortize the initial cost of the machine over the glasses of fizzy water that we made with it. That's amortization. Now consider having to rehash each of the elements in the set. Each of those elements cost O1 expected time to add them to the set earlier. Now we amortize the cost of rehashing the set over those elements. Each element now cost us expected time O1 initially to add it, plus expected time O1 to rehash it. In total, that's still expected amortized time O1 for each element.